In the lesson that follows, we will revisit the functions in Excel and specifically see the copying and pasting of functions or formulas using relative and fixed referencing.
We've been talking about functions in this course, and in some lessons we've also used them. Functions make Excel a very powerful software. So let us visit them again to emphasize their importance. The general format of entering a function in Excel is to put a is equal to sign, then you put in the function name, and then within parentheses, you put in the arguments that the function takes. For example, if you wish to sum up the numbers in a spreadsheet in cells A1 through A25, so you would do a is equal to, then the function sum, then within parentheses, you type in the arguments that this function takes, which is the cell reference A1 through A25. Let us look at yet another example by opening the Excel file survey results. So this file contains data on opinions about a new dining facility on campus. A group of college students across 4 years, year one, year two, year three, year four, were surveyed on their opinions about a new dining facility on a college campus. Did they approve of the dining facility? Did they disapprove? Or did they have no opinion about the new dining facility? So in this table, we are provided with partial results of the survey. Why partial? Because in this data, we know the total number of students who approved of the dining facility, who disapproved of it, and who had no opinions. However, we do not know how this total number is distributed across the 4 years. Or in other words, how this number, how many of the 100 people who had no opinion, how many of them belong to year one, how many of them belong to year two, how many year three, and how many year four. On the other hand, another piece of information that we have is, we have the total number of year one students who participated in the survey, the total number of year two students, 180 students, total number of year three, and total number of year four students. And now, given this information, we are tasked to fill in these empty boxes within the table under the assumption that the year of a particular student is independent of his or her opinion about the dining facility. We begin by calculating the total number of students, which is nothing but the sum of the row totals, which also would be equal to the sum of these column totals. So let's enter the totals. Let's enter the function is equal to, then the sum, open parenthesis, and then we could add up the column totals C8 through F8, close parenthesis, enter. So the total number of students that participated in the survey was 600. Now notice that 200 is 1/3 of 600, or in other words, 1/3 of students who participated in the survey approved of the dining facility. So if we were to fill up these boxes in the first row here, we would expect that 1/3 of year one students approved of the dining facility, 1/3 of year two, 1/3 of year three, and 1/3 of year four. Or in other words, the very first box would be 1/3 of 120, which is equal to 40 students. Now we could have also used a formula for that, and the formula for that is nothing but the row total multiplied by the column total divided by the grand total. So let's enter the formula is equal to the row total multiplied by the column total divided by the grand total, and which gives us the answer 40. To populate this entire table, we can now copy this formula and paste it across the entire table. However, before we copy and paste, we need to put in appropriate referencing in this formula. For example, if you look at this formula, the denominator is the grand total. And when we copy and paste this formula, we always want the grand total to refer to cell G8. So we need to fix the column G and row 8. So we do that by putting a dollar sign in front of G and a dollar sign in front of the numeral 8. In terms of the numerator, which is my row total multiplied by column total, when I copy and paste this formula across the first row, I always want my row total to refer to cell G5. However, when I'm copying and pasting this formula in the next row, I want my row total to refer to cell G6. And in the third row, I want my row total to refer to cell G7. So I do that by fixing the column G, because the column G always remains the same, but I do not fix the row. So this will allow a relative referencing of the row, but a fixed referencing of the column. And by the same logic, my column total, when I copy and paste this formula, I would want to fix the row by putting a dollar sign in front of the numeral 8, while I'll allow the column to be relatively referenced. So this puts in appropriate referencing in the formula, which is now ready to be copied and pasted across the entire table. So I give an enter here, and now I could select this cell and put my cursor at the bottom right hand corner of the cell till I see a small plus sign and drag it across the row. So this will copy it for the entire row, and this entire row I can then drag it down so that formula is copied across the entire table. And if you look at any cell, you would see that the formula has been appropriately copied. Row total multiplied by column total divided by grand total. And so is the case with all the cells. Row total multiplied by column total divided by grand total.